so beautiful.
Happy and honored that you have traveled all the way here from South Africa to make us a community of sacred witnesses to this most holy event in your lives. We are especially grateful that children Brendan, Liam, Leah, and Calvin join us today to honor us. We know that we are present physically, but also spiritually. The marriage of Rowland and Sonja is more than the sum of the two parts that are joined today. It is infused with divine and human love, shown by the presence of all who are here. We now share this passage of heavenly love from the book of Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. That is the word of the Lord. Two souls destined to be together, a match made in heaven revealed on earth. You first auspiciously came together as colleagues and friends. Immediately in your working environment, you related to each other and became close personal friends. After you left your professional conditions, you moved in together 10 years ago. Let's talk for a moment about the number 10. The number 10 is important in the unseen system in our lives. It is the sum of the numbers 3 plus 3 plus 4. 3 is a number representing heaven, and this appears twice. The number 4 represents earth and appears once. This tells us that your two souls were brought together in heaven and appear here on earth. 10 is used over and over in our scriptures to represent completeness, a critical mass, if you will. For 1 is the physical presence and 0 the spiritual presence. A number representing life, love, yin and yang, the ocean and the sand, the open sky and the clouds. These are the duality of existence and the reason why two people choose to hold hands through this life, complementing and orbiting each other. Rowland, you say that Sonja smiles and completes you. She jokes and has a sense of humor, keeping your life easygoing, fun-loving. She is nurturing, kind-hearted, and loving towards you. Sonja, you say that Rowland is your soulmate, your everything. He is kind. He takes care of you, and he's supportive of you as an individual, emotionally, spiritually, and intellectually. And most importantly, you are best friends, a refuge from the rest of the world. The space between you is a holy and intimate place where only your love for each other exists. In the 10 years you have been together, not only are you raising a beautiful family, but also sharing adventures like mountaineering and traveling within South Africa, Indonesia, Mauritius, and the United Kingdom, along with your shared love of cricket and football. Belie a future of hopes and dreams that portend many years of happiness, health, longevity, and loving and close family. Today is truly a glorious day, as today both of you are blessed with the greatest of God's gifts, the gift of abiding love and devotion between a man and a woman. All present here today, and those who are here in heart, wish you both all of the joy, happiness, and success that the world has to offer. And how appropriate to get married on this beautiful beach. Harmonious and balanced, ebbing and flowing, constantly different yet always the same. Like your marriage, it is protected only through the goodwill of those who believe in it and support it, such as those who are here with us today. By choosing to spend your lives together, you have pledged to share the responsibility of making this union one of equality, understanding, and strength. And now you are making your promise sacred. And so I ask you, in the presence of God and these sacred witnesses, Rowland, are you here freely and willingly to pledge your hand and your heart in marriage to Sonja?
Yes, I am.
Sonja, are you here freely and willingly to pledge your hand and your heart in marriage to Rowland? Sonja and Rowland, life is given to us as individuals, and yet we learn to live together. We yearn to live together. Man and woman were created together. The creation of love is given to us by our family first, like those who are sitting with us today. Learning to love and living together is both life's greatest challenge and life's greatest reward. As you travel through life together, remember that the true measure of success, the true avenue to joy and peace, is to be found within the love you hold in your hearts. Support that love. Hold it, protect it, nurture it. As it grows and matures, soon you will have what we know is before us, a vision of splendor and paradise. I'm now going to ask you to say your marriage vows. Do you want to say it from here?
I, Rowland, take you, Sonja, to be my lawfully wedded wife, my constant friend, my faithful partner, my love. From this day forward, in the presence of God and our family, I offer you my solemn vow to be your faithful partner in sickness and in health, in good times and bad times, and in joy as well as sorrow. I promise to love you unconditionally, to support you in all your goals, to honor you, to respect you, to laugh with you, and to cry with you, and to cherish you for as long as we both shall live.
You done? Okay.
From the moment I first saw you, I knew you were the one for me, and the one with whom I wanted to share my life. Your heart and mine inspire me to be the best person I can be, and I vow to help create a life that we can cherish and inspire our love for each other. I promise to love you in all different seasons of our lives, in good times and in bad times, with all I have to give and with all that I am. I promise to love you just as you are, and to grow old by your side with your soulmate. I promise to be your helpmate, God intended for you to be. I will honor you as my spiritual leader. I will cover you in prayer and ensure that God always remains the anchor in our lives. I will work alongside you in support of your God-given vision for our family. I promise to be honest, respectful, and human. I will love you and be faithful to you alone until God calls us home. I promise to love you for eternity. This is my solemn pledge to you and to God our Father. I'm truly blessed to have you as my best friend and husband. Thank you for being here.
May we have the rings, please. Sonja, I ask you to take Roland's ring. Rowland, I ask you to take Sonja's ring. Rowland, I ask you to put Sonja's ring on her finger. Hold it there while I ask you. Do you, Rowland, take this woman, Sonja, to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold, in sickness and in health, in good times and woe, for richer or poorer, keeping yourself solely unto her for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Please secure the ring on Sonja's finger. Sonja, I ask you to put Roland's ring on his finger. Hold it there while I ask you.
Tilt your hand so the camera can see it. There you go.
Sonja, did you take this man, Roland, to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold, in sickness and health, to love, honor, and obey, in good times and woe, for richer or poorer, keeping yourself solely unto him for as long as you both shall live? You may secure the ring on Roland's finger. I ask you to keep holding hands. Keep holding hands. Because we know that these are the hands of your best friend. They hold you strongly and are full of love for you as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately touch you, hold you, and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch, give you comfort like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will wipe the tears from your eyes. These are the hands that will tenderly hold you as you grow old. The hands that will help you to hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours. Still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. What God has willed to be together, let no human tear apart. Rowland and Sonja, in the presence of your children as witnesses, as well as in front of the great ocean, the moon, the sun, and the universe, you have spoken the words and performed the rites that unite your lives. I therefore declare your marriage to be valid and binding, and pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.